How do you fight a fire when it's in motion? The challenges faced by Air Force firefighters are unlike any other job in the world. The response times must be instantaneous, and the challenges, whether spatial, chemical, or kinetic, are numerous. The only thing all aircraft fires have in common is their immense stakes. That's why firefighters prepare with top-level training at Duty Fire Academy.
It's a science, how you manage it, how you put it out, how you control it.
The Air Force's unique challenges make its firefighters some of the very best in the world, ready for any situation.
It's not just pulling up on scene and putting water on the fire.
Firefighters must contend with high-intensity scenarios, pressurized systems, immensely powerful machines, and hazardous substances not found in civilian society.
We have a burning flammable liquid. An aircraft spills fuel on the ramp due to a crash.
In addition, these fires burn incredibly hot, such as temperatures between 427 and 816 degrees Celsius.
In order to put that out, you need to cool it, and you need to keep the heat separated from the fuel. Foam is one way of doing that. Foam flows on top of the fuel, it smothers the oxygen away from the fire, puts the fire out.
As technology keeps evolving, so too do the potential problems when it goes wrong. Coordination is key, from inspection to prevention to suppression. When a call comes in, firefighters have to be dressed to go in under 1 minute and arrive in 2 minutes. After that, they have one more minute to reduce the fire by 90%. If temperatures reach 649 degrees Celsius, the plane is done for. Although the extinguishing materials vary by the fire's causes, Air Force firefighters must prepare for every combustion, from jet fuel to live weapons to metal itself burning. If airborne, firefighters have to be careful to preserve the integrity of the plane hull with high-pressure extinguishing methods so as not to give the fire a path into the cabin.
A fire on aircraft spreads very quickly. It'll start one end and spread very quickly to the other end.
In order to be as effective as possible, firefighters also have to memorize the layouts of different model aircrafts, which can vary greatly.
Where it may be as little as a couple of feet in length, all the way up to an aircraft that may be 300 feet long and is loaded with thousands of gallons of fuel.
Air Force firefighters are called upon to help far beyond the airfield. Their special skills are used to combat from natural disasters such as wildfires to commercial airlines.
The Fire Academy was very intense, a very grueling process. We do have a lot of responsibility responding to whatever may happen. But it's a very rewarding career, and I'm proud to be a part of the Air Force and a firefighter.
This episode was presented by the U.S. Air Force. Learn more at airforce.com. For more episodes of Science in the Extremes, check out this one right here. Don't forget to subscribe and come back to Seeker for more episodes.